Hello friends, welcome and Jai Shri Ram to all the friends who visit this channel. So today we are going to discuss a very amazing mechanics problem, and this problem is based on the SHM, simple harmonic motion. So let us see the problem statement. So here it has been given that there is a plank. This is a plank, okay? So this is a plank and on it there is a block. So there is a plank on which a block is kept, and then this plank starts to oscillate. Now this plank starts to oscillate with an amplitude of A and angular frequency of omega, and this angle is maintained at alpha. That means it is oscillating like this. So sometime it is here and there, and so it is maintaining the same angle and oscillating in this direction like this, okay? So the plank starts to oscillate and the block has been kept on it. So the coefficient of friction on this plank is mu, and all the value has been given, L, alpha, A, omega, mu, all have been given. You need to find the time. You need to find the time which block takes to reach the bottom of the plank. So today we will discuss how to find this. This problem may look easy, but it's not so. It's a very good problem, and we will be discussing it with a graphical approach. So let us see. So this is the free body diagram of the block. As you can see, here is the friction. See, let us try to find that what is the tendency of the block, why the friction is acting in the upper direction and the lower direction. See, the friction always acts where the relative velocity is opposite to friction. The relative velocity is opposite to friction. So here you can see that this is the normal reaction. This is the mg cos alpha, this is mg, and there is mg sin theta. Now let us talk about friction. How to determine the direction of friction? So at initial moment, at the very start of the motion, we can say that this is the block, this is the plank, and it start, let us say that it moves here. The block was initially at rest. So if we try to find the relative velocity of the block, it would be in somewhere in the backward direction. So the friction would be opposite to the backward direction, and it would like we will prove that the friction will always act in the forward direction in a due of time. So here I have taken this direction as the positive direction. As you can see here, it has been noted as a positive direction, and in this direction it is the negative direction. This is the positive direction here, and negative direction is upwards. So here now some other important thing is that the value of friction is mu n for static friction, and less than equal to mu n, that is inequality is present for static friction, and for kinetic friction it is mu n. So here you can see that this is for kinetic friction. Now here we can say that the acceleration that the frictional force produces in the block is largest when the block is sliding and the velocity of the block with respect to is in the negative direction. So we can say that yes, as I told you that the friction on the block, the friction that is acting on the block, or the acceleration, that is F by M, this is the acceleration produced due to friction. Acceleration produced due to friction. This would be largest produces in the block is acceleration that frictional force produces in the block is largest. So the value of this acceleration would be largest when the block is sliding, because when the block will be sliding, this inequality would change into the equality and we'll get a maximum value of mu n. So that at that time we can say that yes, it is in the value of mu n is achieved, and it's the maximum value of the frictional force. So the acceleration would already be maximized. And one more important thing is that since the friction would be the relative velocity would be in the negative direction, the friction would be in the forward direction, and it would support the motion. Now, since it supports the motion, we can say that yes, it would increase the acceleration. So these are some important points that we draw from here. Now we should write the value of acceleration. So here I can say that n minus mg cos alpha is equal to 0 from the free body diagram that I drew above. From here we can say that n minus mg cos alpha is equal to 0. And another important thing is f plus mg sin alpha is equal to am. M means mass of the block and a is the acceleration of the block. So for the maximum value of friction, we can say that f should be kinetic friction. As we discussed above, the value of f should be equal to kinetic friction. Now, from that analysis, we can say that f by m plus g sin alpha is equal to a. Now the value of maximum is when f is maximum, that is mu n by m plus g sin alpha. Now here we let use n is equal to mg cos alpha. So here we will say that the maximum acceleration would be g sin alpha plus mu cos alpha. So this is the maximum value of the acceleration, or the peak value of the acceleration. Now here, using this analysis, you can use a calculator and try to find the value of maximum acceleration would be around 5.6 meter per second square. And the maximum acceleration of the board is a omega square, which is 250 meter per second. So we can say that the maximum value of the this is 40 times the value of this. So 5.6 is 1 by 40 of 250. Now this approximately would give me 5.6. So since it is concluding a harmonic motion, how we write it, a omega square, here x is equal to a sin omega t plus phi, so v would be equal to a omega cos omega t plus phi, so acceleration would be minus a omega square sin omega t plus phi. So maximum value of this would be a omega square, okay, but in the backward direction, I must say. So this is 40 times. So the backward acceleration a omega square is 40 times greater than the forward acceleration. This means that initially the block would move in the backward direction, and this gives me an intuition that the friction would be in the frontward direction. So let us see the points that have been noted here. So first of all, we can say that from this analysis we conclude that the block starts to slide almost immediately after the starts of vibration. Please ignore this immediately, I have written it 2 times. From this analysis we can conclude that block starts to slide almost immediately after the starts of vibration. We can say that because since the backward acceleration is very much so here you can say that it slides almost instantaneously. Later we will be doing analysis of adherence of the block with the plank. What is meant by adherence of block with the plank? That how would the contact force between the plank and the block would behave. We need to find that what would be the nature of adherence. Adherence means adhesive force. Adhesive force means the force that sticks two body together, or two body made of different materials together. Well, let us say the solid liquid interference or something like that. That's called adhesive force. And we will be doing a very good analysis on the adherence between the block and the plank. So the next important thing is, consequently, the only friction force acting on the block is a constant magnitude kinetic friction, whilst its direction changes alternatively with respect to the plank. So you can say that one time a omega square is here and another it is a omega square in its direction. So the value of relative acceleration would change with respect to block. The value of relative acceleration would change, and hence I can say that the value of friction will also change. Sometimes it would be in this direction, sometimes it would be in this direction, sometimes in this direction, sometimes in opposite direction. So the value of friction force is changing. And we can say that the only friction force acting on the block is a constant magnitude kinetic friction. So the friction force, we will not use the inequality anywhere such that f is less than equal to mu n. It would always be equal to mu n because a constant magnitude kinetic friction is acting on the body. Okay. So here is a graph. We should admire the graph. We should see how this graph changes. So we already concluded that the friction would change its direction alternatively in the positive and the negative direction. Therefore acceleration would also change alternatively in the positive and the negative direction. So at the very initial moment, we said that acceleration is zero for both the plank and here we are plotting the velocity time graph. So velocity time graph, you can see that v is equal to at type of graph, that linear graphs would be drawn and some u would also be there, u plus at, u plus at. This type of linear graphs has been drawn here, and this is the graph for the plank, the velocity of the plank, and we already derived how to draw the graph, how it came here. So let us see. So here initially at t equal to 0, we can say that the both are having 0. This is increasing at a very lower rate, and you can see this is increasing at a very higher rate and decreasing too in the same time. So we have just drawn the graph to compare some important data. So we can say that at very initial times, let us say at this time, at some time between, we can say that this velocity is very, very less than this velocity. That's why the backwards velocity of A omega is very larger than the frontward velocity of A plus T, because acceleration would be acting in the positive direction. And when we multiply it by time, we will get the V plus. Now here, next important thing is, at the final time, let us say that this time is equal to one time period. And here I can say that this is the graph of A omega sine omega t plus phi, or you can say that A omega, this is the graph of the velocity. So here at this time it would have some initial velocity. Now from here it would decrease, and some so on, like this it would go. So the velocity, when the relative velocity would be in the upward direction, friction force will be in the downward direction. When the velocity relative would be in the downward direction, friction force will act in the upward direction. And accordingly, we have drawn the graphs here. Linear graphs are there. Okay. So always when we achieve a new value, let us zoom in the graph and see it clearly what it tries to say. So as you can see here, that this level, it has been increased, and this is also above than this level. Okay, so this one and then this one. So you can see that consequently, first it decreases, then increases, and there is a constant separation maintained between both the levels. So it is kind of increasing graph. So it is going somewhat like this, and but with a breaks like this, and it is going to try to like that. Okay, so here I can say that this graph is increasing linearly, and at any point of time I can say that this velocity is far greater than this velocity. And here you can see there is not a very big difference between the two velocities. So for a very small time, the acceleration would change its direction, and then you can say that here it is decreasing with a very large value. You can say that here there is a large difference between, so automatically the block would move in the negative direction. So what is the driving force behind the direction of the acceleration? It is the acceleration of the Planck. So here I can say that mod of A plus is greater than mod of A minus. So I already shown you that how the thing works. And if mu is greater than tan alpha, acceleration positive is positive and acceleration negative is negative. That is, here the acceleration would be positive and here the acceleration would be negative. Okay, so here I can say that the average velocity of the block over one period increases all the time, and hence the block drifts downward on the board. So if I say that average velocity, from this graph you can see that the average velocity of the block increases all the time in one period. So this interval is one period, and you can see that it continuously increases like this. So I can say that it continues to move downward. The block drifts downward on the board. The drift velocity of the block increases until the average acceleration of the blocks become zero. So it increases until the average acceleration of the blocks become zero, and at that time it has some initial value that we have already shown, that at this point it is having some value. Acceleration reaches to zero, but since it is having a value, it is upward, it is not on the x-axis. Okay. Now after that, it oscillates about a constant velocity, a constant value v drift. So the drift velocity of the block increases until the average acceleration of the block becomes zero. It would increase until the average acceleration of the block would become zero. Because of the large frequency of the Planck, the steady state is achieved quite quickly. So achieving the steady state, you can say that it would occur very quickly because the frequency of the Planck is quite large. Okay, so the initial transient stage of the motion could be neglected. So at very initial moment, what happens, we can neglect that, or how the block moves and all the stuff that happens at the initial moment could be neglected. And why it would be neglected? Because of the large frequency of the Planck in the steady state. So the steady state is achieved quite quickly. So for the condition for a steady state drift velocity is that average acceleration over a complete cycle is zero. So for, we can say that for steady state, for achieving the steady state, the drift velocity, for condition for steady drift velocity is that average acceleration over a time period. Okay, so we are talking about average acceleration over a time period. So this is T by 2. Actually, when we saw the graph, the above graph, we can say that this is a type of velocity, this is not the drift velocity or the average steady velocity. It is not that drift velocity. Here we are talking about the average velocity of the block over a one period increases all the time and hence the block shift downward. The drift velocity of the block increases until the average acceleration of the block becomes zero. After that, it oscillates about a constant value V drift. So this has been shown in the graph which is given here. So here the condition has been applied that the average velocity in the first loop and the average acceleration in the second loop over one time period is zero. Now applying this condition, we will get T is equal to T plus plus T. We got two equations. First equation is this and second equation is this. So let us see another important graph. So this is the graph that I was talking about, that this is the velocity of the plank and this is the constant velocity about which the oscillations take place. Okay, this is the average, this is the constant velocity about which the oscillations take place. And for a t positive is the time during which the velocity is positive, t positive, and there is a t negative also. So I can say that here t positive is this time and t negative is this time. So total t plus and t minus is equal to t, one time period. Okay, so from the above equation, solving the above two equations, here you can see the above equation, putting the value of a plus and a minus from the previous slides, this is the value of when there would be a plus, here it will be plus, and then will be minus, it would be negative here. Okay, so using these two values I can find the value of the acceleration, and putting all the value, you can say that t plus is equal to 1 minus tan alpha by mu t by 2. You can see the calculations, I will show you. I'll not explain them, these are basic linear equations. Here you can see, you put them, you solve them, and you'll get the answer as 1 minus tan alpha by mu t by 2. So very zooming in the graph, this graph that we drew here, that the plank would always oscillate about a constant velocity which is called drift velocity or the V drift. Zooming in the graph for that, we can get this, we can get some important observations. So what are the important observations? You can say that since the block will drift along a velocity which is constant, this is that velocity about which the, somewhere later it would achieve here, and there would be the sinusoidal curve here also. Okay, as you can see in the above graph, here it again achieves from this point, it again achieves this value, and again this achieves this value, and again next it would achieve the same value. So V drift is constant, and about that an oscillation is taking place. Okay, so let us say that this is the level of V drift. Now what would happen? Initially it would decrease, increase, and then again reach the same value, again reach the same value, and it would oscillate about the drift velocity. Now zooming in some portion of that, we can say that the total interval, which is the, and the total interval that is here is t plus. Now this particular is t by 2, t plus by 2, this is t plus by 2. As you can see from the symmetry of the curve, I am saying that this is t plus by 2, and from here to here, from here to here, it is pi by omega, pi by omega. Now this particular point is pi by 2 by pi by 2 omega. This particular point, the midpoint of the graph, is pi by 2 omega. This particular point of the graph is pi by 2 omega. Now so this particular interval, this particular interval, because we need to find the intersection, or we need to find the V drift, if we need to find the V drift, this is the velocity V drift, that is the velocity on the sinusoidal curve at a particular time, which is given by, at a particular time, which is given by pi by 2 omega, pi by 2 omega minus t plus by 2. So let us say that this is equal to t naught, this is equal to t naught, this at this particular time we will put it in the sinusoidal function, the sinusoidal function for drift velocity, and we will get the value of v drift. So v drift is equal to velocity of the plank at a time t naught, v plank at t naught. This would be approximately equal to that. Okay, it would not be exactly equal to, but it would be approximately equal to that. Now we can say that drift is equal to v plank at a time this, so it is a omega sine omega, and putting all the values of the time here, we get a omega cos omega t plus by 2 is equal to v drift. Now putting the value of t plus by 2, we'll get a omega cos 1 minus tan alpha by mu pi by 2. Okay, so putting these all the values here, you can say that a omega cos pi by 2 minus pi tan alpha by 2 mu. So here it would be like this, and it would be a omega pi tan alpha by 2 mu. This is the value of v drift. So the value of time, or the time which it takes, is equal to L by a omega sine pi tan alpha by 2 mu. This is the final answer of the problem, and it would be approximately 18.8 seconds. So I hope you like the question. It's a very amazing problem and a tough one, looking easy. So again, Jai Shri Ram.